Cotto and Yuri Foreman. Roy Jones talked to you about the height. There you see the difference. Foreman at 5'11". Cotto is maybe 5'8", and in the past, via his style deficiency, has shrunken himself down and got lower to be even shorter than 5'8". That's one of the things Stewart is working on, trying to get him to stand up straight. But Cotto is oddly built and has an arm length advantage of 1 inch, measured from the arm length to the end of the fist. He weighed in a half pound under the 154-pound limit. Remember, it's Cotto's first visit to this weight class. Foreman, a career junior middleweight, weighed in right on the number at 154. And there is a look at Miguel Cotto. That expression does not portray worry. That is the serious, sometimes taciturn expression of a no-nonsense fighter. And Emmanuel Stewart by his side, training Cotto for the first time, and now they leave the dressing room area to come to the ring, which is in right center field here in Yankee Stadium. So Roy Jones, this is a guy who only seeks to fight the best, by and large. And he was given a chance in his battles with Margarito and with Pacquiao. Of course, the Margarito loss may or may not have been legitimate. In the Pacquiao loss, maybe he fought the wrong fight. This is a real trial for this guy to get himself back into the mode of believing he can win tonight.
Yeah, it's a real trial, and it's a great opportunity, because in those fights he lost, he fought against two big punchers. This guy is not a big puncher. Therefore, he should be able to go in a little bit more relentlessly and try to land his big punch to find out what this bigger guy can take. But there's still questions of whether Foreman can endure his punches or not. And Miguel is moving up to 154 pounds for the first time.
Max, there was evidence in Madison Square Garden last year that Miguel does respond to crowd noise. Clearly, Puerto Rican fans helped him to his win over Joshua Clotty.
Yeah, you know, Miguel Cotto, when he was a younger guy, Jim, was uncomfortable training with his uncle, uncomfortable training in Puerto Rico, uncomfortable making the weight at 140 and maybe even 147. And he fought that way, like a fighter who'd been made to feel uncomfortable, like a rough, rugged guy. And then recently, he left his uncle, and he moved his training camp to Tampa, and he moved up in weight. All things that made him feel more comfortable. And Jimmy's been fighting like a more comfortable fighter without that edge.
We'll see if Emmanuel Stewart has made him uncomfortable enough to regain his edge tonight. A man with as many difficult fights on his dossier as anyone else in the sport over the course of the past few years. And Roy Jones, Max Kellerman and I called his fight against Manny Pacquiao from ringside in November. So let's take a look at what happened, and you tell us your perspective on Cotto's trial against Pacquiao.
Well, basically, I think what happened here is he came out, he was trying to bang with Pacquiao, but he's a little bit too slow. He's throwing big punches, and that's why this big punch may hit him, because Cotto's a sharper, I mean, not a sharper, Pacquiao's a much sharper, quicker puncher. These short, quick punches are what really got to him. And that's what I'm afraid of for him tonight, because this guy's not a power puncher, he's a short, quick puncher. Pacquiao's a powerful, quick puncher, so we'll see what he can take. Also, we want to find out in this fight, how much did the Margarito fight truly take out of him?
Should his trainer Joe Santiago have thrown in the towel much earlier than the 12th round when the fight was eventually stopped?
Yes, he did, because he allowed him to take much more punishment than he needed to take, especially being that he took so much punishment from Margarito, who already had bad hand wraps.
And you know, losing to Manny Pacquiao is like losing to Roy when Roy was in his prime. What are you going to do? I mean, how do you counteract what Pacquiao does?
Now here's Yuri Foreman, who on the undercard that night won this 154-pound title belt against a Puerto Rican fighter, Daniel Santos. But Santos, who had not fought in 16 months and who barely made weight for the fight, was clearly not anywhere near in shape, and he made it an easy night for Foreman.
Yeah, he did. And this guy, once again, Santos was a big puncher, much like Cotto, who depended on catching this guy, knocking him out. But he couldn't catch him, and when he did catch him, he couldn't hurt him. As a matter of fact, this guy, Yuri, turned out to knock Santos down and become a power puncher more so than Santos was.
It's really an interesting conundrum, Max. There's no comparison in the competition they've faced. Cotto has fought in a different league. There's no comparison in the punishment they've taken. Yuri Foreman is largely untouched compared to Cotto, who has taken as much punishment as any fighter.
Yes, Yuri Foreman does have some tough wins that some people even thought he lost to Thompson, for instance, but some tough wins against the fighters in the kind of fights that make you tougher, that get you ready for moments like this, you would think. But clearly, Cotto has faced the who's who of boxing in and around his weight division, and Foreman hasn't faced anything like that kind of competition.
And he's never faced an event like this or a moment like this, Roy. How much of a change can it bring?
It can bring a lot of change, but the thing about it is we have an awesome God. God has prepared him for this already. He went from country to country to country to pursue this, and now he's here at the Mecca, the biggest place for boxing. There's no way he should be prepared to stand up under this pressure.
There are the notable wins for Yuri Foreman. Both fighters are in the ring. There's a wellspring of excitement in Yankee Stadium. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the home of the 40-time American League champion, 27-time Major League Baseball world champion, New York Yankees. This is Yankee Stadium, and this is the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Super Welterweight Championship of the World. Presented by Bob Arum's Top Rank Boxing in association with the New York Yankees, and sponsored by Under Armour, the most technical performance apparel and footwear brand in the world, and AT&T, rethink possible with AT&T. Sanctioned by the New York State Athletic Commission, Chairwoman Melvina Lathan, WBA President Gilberto Mendoza. At ringside, the three judges scoring this bout, Dan Ackerman, Tony Paolillo, and Steve Weisfeld. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, referee Arthur Mercanti Jr. And now, we return to a legendary sports tradition, a title fight outdoors in a ballpark. From Yankee Stadium, Bronx, New York City, New York, USA, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Fighting out of the blue corner, wearing Yankee pinstripes, officially weighing in at 153.5 pounds. His professional record, 34 victories, including 27 knockouts, with only 2 defeats. The challenger, former 2-time light welterweight world champion, former welterweight world champion from Caguas, Puerto Rico, Miguel Angel Cotto. And fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with gold, official weight 154 pounds. His professional record, a perfect one, consisting of 28 fights, 28 victories, including 8 knockouts, by way of Haifa, Israel. Now training and fighting out of Brooklyn, New York, the reigning, defending, undefeated WBA Super Welterweight Champion of the World, Yuri Foreman.
Miguel Sr., Dad, rest in peace. Good evening, Yuri. You received the rules early in the night. Let's have a nice, clean fight, gentlemen, and good luck to both of you.
Is Yuri Foreman more than just a curiosity? And speaking of curiosity, The boxing world is curious. Does Miguel Cotto still want to fight? Does he still really want to fight?
Come on, fellas, let's go. We gotta be faster. Come on.
Arthur McCanny Jr., the referee, trying to clear the ring a little bit more rapidly. Cotto with his back turned. Yuri Foreman steps to the center of the ring. And the crowd erupts in a cheer just at the thought that they're watching a fight in Yankee Stadium. Good jab by Cotto. A key weapon for Miguel. Can he get the jab there against the taller Foreman? Straight right hand by Foreman. Cotto firing his jab between Foreman's guard.
Can't wait to see how Foreman reacts to Cotto's left body shot, too, if Cotto comes and brings it to the fight tonight.
Cotto's left hook to the body, once one of the most debilitating weapons in the sport, seems to have receded a bit in recent years as he's gone more to the jab and the right hand. There's the jab again. And he pounds Foreman's face and knocks him back with it. This is a very good first minute for Miguel Cotto. This is the kind of start he would have wanted.
Cotto's always had exquisite timing with his left jab. Made up for a lack of hand speed at times.
He looks alive. He looks lively, dancing on his feet. This is not the guy who was beaten down at the end of the Pacquiao fight. How long will it last?
Yeah, because he started out good against Pacquiao in the first two rounds.
Cotto just dipped into one of that, those deep knee bends of his. That's what Stewart probably doesn't want to see. That's what he does want to see. And he almost got the left hook to the body, although Foreman says, no, it landed on my hip. Foreman has backed away in the face of Cotto's assault in this round, and his punches are falling short.
Well, he's not having a problem with that. You got to remember, he's the guy who's out here trying to learn this fight game. He's trying to figure out how this goes. This is his first time truly being on this level of boxing with a guy across the ring from him. So it's smart for him to take his time and ease his way into this fight.
Break! Break! Nice, bro.
Foreman's not sure if he can take a Cotto punch yet. Cotto knows he can take a Foreman punch right now.
If Miguel Cotto needed a confidence-building round, maybe this was it. As he has landed his jab, he has knocked Foreman back off his spot, and he stayed away from Foreman's punches.
Him to take the pressure off, put the pressure on you with a jab. The jab is your game, not his. Now what's happening is it's obvious. Soon as he jabs, he's jumping in. You gotta know he's jumping in. When he does that, sidestep him, then catch him with both hands. Okay?
Very beautiful. Just keep doing what you're doing. Nothing, just keep in the jab, jab. Jab is working always over his glove. That's why he's having problems. Because you're going over top, and he can't figure out why you hit.
Right, you see Cotto land a beautiful left jab. As a matter of fact, he makes it a double jab, and it's a great weapon for him early in the fight. If he can land that jab, that usually spells disaster for the other guy.
Copy box numbers in round one. Cotto 10 out of 37, including 5 out of 25 jabs. Foreman 7 out of 32 in the round. You heard Joe Greer's opinion of the round. He's Foreman's trainer, a former Passaic, New Jersey policeman, who has tremendous respect for Yuri. Foreman more active now as round two begins.
Yeah.
can make an older fighter feel his age. But Yuri Foreman's never been a really active fighter, in spite of being pretty quick.
No, he hasn't.
He's active on his feet. He doesn't throw a lot of punches.
Well, the reason he's active on his feet, though, is because he knows he's not a big puncher. And he knows most big punchers need to sit down on their feet to deliver power shots. But if he can keep them changing directions, then they can't sit down and hit him with the big bombs. See right there, Cotto has to hold that hook because Yuri's gone.
Yeah, right now, the jab is the best punch for Cotto.
Only thing going to be able to land for a little while.
Has Cotto thrown any left hooks to the body so far?
Only one, and it landed on the hip, and it wasn't really fully thrown.
That used to be the killer shot in boxing, was Cotto's hook to the body.
Exactly, but once again, because how much Yuri is moving around him, he can't plant his feet to land that shot. That's a shot that is a very powerful shot, so your feet have to be stationary to throw it.
Once again, Cotto knocks Foreman back with a solid jab. That time, Yuri stepped into it, elevating the impact of the punch.
And it may have hurt Yuri because he's staying away like a hurt fighter.
The difference in hand speed is apparent. But until that left hook landed, Foreman wasn't making it mean anything. Now Foreman gets more offensively aggressive, sticks his jab through a combination before that. Right hand lands for Cotto.
That hurt Foreman. That right hand
hurt
Foreman.
His feet momentarily wobbled.
That right hand hurt Foreman badly.
I think Cotto understands now that Foreman may have a little bit of problem. But Miguel is going to stay in his envelope and box.
He's not doing that by choice, Jim. He's only doing that because Yuri won't stand still and allow him to come out of that envelope.
It's the solid impact of Miguel Cotto that's making the difference in the fight. His punches simply mean more in the first two rounds than do those of Yuri Foreman.
Most definitely.
Tune in June 22 for the next Real Sports. We'll profile Dallas Braden, the Oakland A's player who pitched a perfect game and got credit for it on Mother's Day. And coming in August, Hard Knocks, training camp of the New York Jets, a weekly five-episode series bringing you an all-access look at one of the NFL's hottest teams as it prepares for the coming season.
Still jumping in. When he jumps in, take a short step over to the right, right uppercut, left hook. Now remember, keep your left hand high. He's coming right over top of it all the time. That's where he's getting his money from. Close the bank down. Don't give him no more money that side, all right? And when
you see Cotto fan a left jab, which he landed earlier, and that enabled him to land a beautiful straight right hand. The best right hand of the fight, the best punch of the fight, in fact. And I think that right hand really hurt Yuri Foreman.
Copy box total through round two. Cotto 22 out of 71. Foreman 17 out of 70. Cotto with a 10-6 edge in power connects. And Harold Lederman has given the first two rounds to Miguel. And that's significant because Cotto has an area on his left eyebrow which could open easily if Foreman lands a right hand there. I'm not saying it's as bad as what happened to Israel Vasquez against Rafael Marquez, but that eyebrow was opened against Clady, against Pacquiao, and against Margarito. Good left hook upstairs by Cotto. So the bottom line is Cotto can't afford to be behind in rounds if the fight were to be stopped because of his cut.
Both Cotto and Foreman cut easily. And for that reason, exactly what you mentioned, Jim, these early rounds are significant.
Foreman just took a dangerous chance of exchanging a left hook with Cotto. And I don't think that's very smart because he's not a power puncher like Cotto is.
You sometimes see guys land simultaneous hooks. And if that happens here, you don't expect Foreman to be the beneficiary.
No, you don't.
Foreman's mouth guard drops out of his mouth. Just dropped to the canvas. No particular reason. Cotto landed a really good right hand body shot. And that backed Foreman off the game.
It almost looked like Foreman spit it out.
There's the left hook to the body. Max Kellerman has been looking for that Cotto weapon. Hard right hand by Foreman. Best shot of the fight for him.
The guy coming forward isn't always the brawler, and the guy going backward isn't always the puncher, isn't always the boxer, rather. Miguel Cotto's outboxing Yuri Foreman here with superior technique, even though he's also the one coming forward, landing the harder shots.
On the basis of only 8 minutes of information, you would have to say so far it looks like the marriage of Cotto and Stewart is figuring to be a success. But we'll see if Miguel can stick with the plan.
Yeah, if he can maintain his jab and keep it small like that, he definitely will be okay. Definitely will be okay.
Unquestionably fighting a smarter fight than was the case early on against Pacquiao.
Break! Time! Go to each one. Go to each one. Come here, son. Come on. No. Come on. You don't want any coaching. You clean it. No coaching from the
this
corner.
This is to put Foreman's mouthpiece back
in. I know it is, man. Time in.
Interesting. He gets the opponent's corner to clean the mouthpiece.
So there's no coaching. He don't get the opposing coach time to talk to his fighter.
There's a mouse under Miguel Cotto's right eye. Perhaps the product of that power right hand that Foreman landed earlier in this round. Now Cotto's more active again. Foreman got in a little left hook before the end of the round.
You set that hook up nicely just now because you stepped over with your right hand up and you hit it. You were hiding behind and then you threw your hook, okay? Listen, step over to your right. Step to the right.
While you enjoy the action, you can also log on to HBO.com/boxing and check out our live Punch Zone site. You'll be able to see and keep track of the Punch Zone stats, showing you where fighters are hit as they occur during our live coverage.
Yeah, he may have won that round, so we got to get back to the jab. The jab was making a difference, but we quit jabbing. And keep in mind all the round, like, is scoring. Remember, if he gets some points, get them back before the round, okay?
Jabs through round three. Cotto 15 out of 56, according to CompuBox. Foreman throwing more, but landing slightly fewer, 12 out of 73. Harold, how do you have it through three?
Attention, 3-0, 30-27, Miguel Cotto. Jim, I think he's just doing more damage. I mean, Yuri Foreman has to pick up the pace. I can't help thinking this, but it's just a thought.
Hard right hand by Foreman. And the left hook. Sudden offensive rally for Foreman. And now he sticks the right. And now the hand speed is a problem for Cotto.
Yuri Foreman, towards the end of the last round, started to fight his way back into this fight. And in fact, Emmanuel Stewart told Cotto in the corner he may have won that round.
And now he said, and he also said to Cotto, if Foreman gets the jump on you and seems ahead in the round, get it back right away. So according to what Stewart instructed Cotto to do, the onus on him is now to try to get even in this round, which Foreman is clearly leading after the early combinations. Right hand by Foreman again. Suddenly, Yuri Foreman has found that right hand leads will land flush against Miguel Cotto.
Yes, he has, and he has a bloody nose himself, but he's landed two beautiful right hands in this round, and that's not good for Cotto.
Foreman showing some pluck here, and he is hitting hard enough with that right hand to get Miguel's attention.
Absolutely, and he landed two little body shots there. And now Cotto tries to go back to the jab to come back in the round. This has been by far Foreman's biggest round of the fight. Cotto partially blocked the left hook. That right hand not as damaging as the others. Now Cotto lands the right hand. Set it up with a little jab.
Beautiful setup with the jab. Like Emmanuel said, when he works off the jab, beautiful things happen for Cotto. But he better quit giving up that straight right lead.
If Foreman were to able to continue to land that straight right lead like that, that could inhibit Cotto's jab.
Not only that, we don't know how much Cotto has taken lately. Well, we know he has taken a lot lately, but we don't know how much his chin can endure at this point in his career.
That'll be ruled a slip.
Seems as though first couple rounds Foreman wasn't sure he belonged, and he believes he belongs now.
Absolutely.
Well, I don't know if he's sure he believes now or if he realizes he's fighting for his life right now. Because right now, Cotto is on the attack. Cotto is very confident. So Foreman really is fighting for his life right now.
Hard left hook by Cotto there. Foreman came back with a left hook of his own.
I think he's fighting more to not be stopped because he's not a knockout puncher, but he's throwing knockout punches right now out of desperation to show that I'm not going to just lay down for you, Cotto.
This is Miguel Cotto, Melissa Guzman, and son. Well, both sons. They're with her.
His nose is bleeding. Keep working it and keep working the jab.
You will recall that Melissa left the Pacquiao fight in, I believe, the ninth round.
Thank you.
Here you see Yuri Foreman land a beautiful straight right hand off of a faint jab. Boom. It was a little bit short, but it was a good punch. Didn't land exactly on the chin. I should say a little high. Then he come back later in the round with another one.
Round five of the scheduled 12. It's a boxing match so far, but a boxing match with some hard exchanges, some excellent combinations by both punchers. The edge in the fight, at least for the first three rounds, was carved out by Miguel Cotto with his jab. Yuri Foreman came back, particularly with his right hand, in the fourth round.
I'd say the first 2.5 rounds for Cotto, and maybe the last round and a half for Foreman. And Roy, whether it's that Foreman's gaining confidence or that Cotto's forcing him to fight better, it looks as though Foreman has found something in the last round and a half.
Yeah, he found something. He found out that if he don't hurry up and do something, he's going to be laying down here. So I think that's what he found. But he definitely found a straight right hand that is being effective for him if he continues to throw it.
Off the last two rounds, I would also observe, here's an excellent left hook by Foreman and an excellent left hook by Cotto. The observation, Cotto's left hook is making a comeback. Showing up in the arsenal again.
And it also throwing a beautiful left uppercut on the inside. He's hit him with a left uppercut quite a few times after he's thrown the left hook.
Jabbing to the body there was Cotto. Foreman can dance all night. The footwork will never stop. Good left hook by Cotto in the middle of that.
So to me, Cotto has him fighting a little bit desperately now. And that's why Cotto can land these big shots, because he has to take desperate risks to try to land something to keep himself in the fight. And Cotto is taking advantage of that with the counter left hook.
Yeah, Cotto doesn't take any time to recover from Foreman's big shots. Foreman seems to need a few seconds to recover whenever Cotto lands something big. And you see the blood streaming down both sides of Yuri's nose. Good left hand again by Cotto, finishing the exchange. As Foreman has thrown combinations, the number of exchanges has increased. Cotto is finishing some of these exchanges now with good left hooks.
See Cotto starting to roll his shoulders a little bit and find a kind of offensive rhythm, at least in terms of the distance between he and Foreman.
And now holding his gloves up in a defensive peekaboo a little bit more often. Maybe trying to slow down a little of Yuri's offense. Emmanuel Stewart told us, Roy, that when he got to Tampa to take over Cotto's training camp, he said Cotto's footwork was a mess. I think his footwork has been excellent in there tonight.
It looks a lot better than it has looked in the past.
You know what else is pretty good, guys? This fight.
Oh, heck yeah.
Which was not expected to be a good action fight, but a pretty interesting fight so far.
Agreed. Another left hook.
Now he's coming in. Yes, yeah, out of order. Now he's coming in trying to fight, which is better. He's slowing down slowly. And you look much stronger than he does. Much ferrity. Just keep working the jab.
There's Layla Lidecker. the Hungarian-born wife of Yuri Foreman. He met her in the boxing gym. He says that they have, in the past, sparred with one another. She accused him of hitting her too hard. Apparently, she doesn't share the opinion of Yuri's punching power, which is common among ringside media.
She's the first fighter to ever accuse Yuri Foreman of that.
He see Yuri come in straight ahead like he's been doing, but about the third punch, Cotto comes with a beautiful counter left hook, and that hook has been very effective all night long. What he does is wait for Yuri to come straight in, which Yuri does once he jumps ahead, and he's countering with a beautiful check hook.
Combi box numbers through the fifth round. Cotto averaging 11 out of 36, Yuri 9 out of 33. Feels like more activity than that. And a fairly interesting free-flowing fight as we reach the middle, or the near midpoint in the sixth round.
Anyone remember any clinches so far?
Not one.
I mean, I think Yuri Foreman is showing the temperament of a real fighter here in the face of a much more experienced, harder punching star.
I don't think Foreman could possibly lose any fans as the result of the way he's fought so far. It's kind of interesting to see him with the blood streaming down his face like this. Pressing the action and trying to land his right hand. But Cotto has been the superior boxer as he has made big progress from the apparent doldrums of his setbacks in the last year or two.
And he's been relentless with his attack, and it's smart because right here he can take chances because he's fighting a guy that he knows he's much stronger than. So he can take good gambles, which are not smart for Yuri to be taking, but this is right down Cotto's alley.
First time at 154, Cotto looks comfortable at the weight. He'll be a little short for this division. Earlier you saw Martirosyan, who's 6 feet, also fights at 154. Left hook again.
This jab from Cotto has been very beautiful tonight.
Good combination there. Jab, right hand, left hook across the top. Blocked everything but the one right hand from Foreman and
clean now, boys.
A near headbutt.
When Foreman punches, he usually lands. The only problem is when he comes straight ahead, Cotto counters, and he gets caught with a better punch than he's landing.
Everybody thought that Foreman's speed and lateral movement would leave Cotto in the dust. Cotto doesn't seem to have been bothered by the lateral movement at all. He's landing his punches when he wants to.
Yes, he is, because Foreman's punching power isn't enough to scare him so that he can take the risk that he needs to take to land those punches.
He can walk right in.
Exactly.
And that's why Foreman is the opponent for Cotto tonight. Because when you're trying to rehabilitate a fighter's confidence, oftentimes you put him in with a guy who's not such a great puncher.
Look at Cotto matching footwork with Yuri Foreman. Look at him moving side to side in the same rhythm as Foreman and staying right with him. That was not expected.
Not at all.
Listen, give me a wet cloth, please.
Here, right here.
Listen. Let's string him out. Let's get him in the late rounds, okay? Let's start moving him towards
there. Close your eye and relax.
You got grease in there?
Listen. Here's a punch zone look at the punches somebody which have been landed down by Miguel Cotto on Yuri Foreman through round six.
All right, listen.
And you see the 34 punches on the chin. Many of those are jabs. Recently, left hooks have been added into the mix. Cotto's sometimes vaunted right hand hasn't been that big a factor tonight, but his left hand has been winning him the fight. A rare smile from Miguel Cotto as Emmanuel Stewart scrambles out of the ring. We are past the midway point of the fight into round seven. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Look at him, 59, 55,
5-1, Miguel Cotto. You know, Jim,
nice
to me,
to
this is a very easy fight to score. You got one guy that's always on his toes, can't get any power because he's on his toes.
Hey, knock that off.
Another guy, flat-footed, landed hard hooks. I mean, the flat-footed guy is just doing more damage in every round. The only thing that Yuri Foreman needs is another foot. If this ring was 1 foot bigger, he might be doing better, but he ain't getting that 1 foot, he's losing. 5-1, Cotto. Oh.
Foreman apparently trips over a photographer.
His knee gave up.
You're right.
No, he has suffered
You're
an
right?
injury.
Wanna walk it off? Give me time. Walk it off, champ. Suck it up, kid.
I think this is it, fam. I don't think he'll be able to make it.
Was it just a fall?
I think so. I think he just fell, and I think his knee gave away.
You okay?
Harold, does he have 5 full minutes?
Well, that's what Austin can't do. Definitely give him up to 5 minutes if he needs it.
I'll give you 5 minutes, kid.
And you hear McCanty say, I'll give you 5 minutes. This could be the end of the fight. Foreman without legs
your ankle?
Is like Cotto without fists.
You ready? Time in. Suck it up, kid.
Foreman limps back to the center of the ring, clearly compromised. Cotto may just go in for the kill.
For sure. And Foreman can't take his body shot. If he can't throw with a good body shot, this fight might be over anyway.
Crowd comes to life. They realize the danger for Foreman. He's got a brace on that knee. Yuri Foreman hobbling on the right knee. He's done. There's no way he can continue in the fight at this point. Miguel Cotto, I think, is going to get a victory here, as it looks as though Yuri Foreman has a legitimate and serious knee injury.
Doc, suck it up. Hey, Doc, you want more time? You're a game guy, you all right? You want to go?
How courageous is this, or how foolish?
This is a fighter we're watching here in Yuri Foreman.
The crowd is in a fever pitch. The Foreman fans are in ecstasy because their man is fighting
and trying
to get through it. The Cotto fans are in ecstasy because their man is closing in on a big win. Oh. Left hook knocks the mouthpiece out of Foreman's mouth. That was a brilliant uppercut hook by Cotto.
Yep.
So much stronger than Foreman. Hammering him now. Yuri without footwork tries to fight back. Hard right hand by Foreman. High drama in Yankee Stadium.
And this is worthy of those old ballpark fights right now.
Now you have a cut over that bad eye. I think that bad eye got hurt just now. Oh, good body shot.
Cotto's landing some heavy leather in this round.
Yep. That bad eye is bothering him. See, he's his hands at it.
McCanty is talking to Foreman as Cotto stalks him around the ring. Good right hand by Rory Foreman.
You gotta stay out of that wet corner.
Good hook by Cotto. Foreman with the weakest possible lateral movement.
Great. Time.
Round 7 comes to a close.
Where's it back? Do you want me to stop it?
In a moment, Roy. Oh, here it is. Here's the first fall. Show us what happened here.
Well, it looks like he was just moving, and right there, you saw his leg go, and he tried to plant on that knee, and it just went. I told you, his knee just gave away on him. It wasn't nothing he tripped over. He tried to plant. Watch again. He tried to plant and throw it right hand. See that? He would slip that time.
That's the second
that,
fall.
That one hurt worse because the water caused his knee to go out from under him. But the first one, he just planted, and his knee just gave away on him.
And he obviously needs some lateral support on that knee. He's fighting with that brace.
Power shots in round 7. Cotto landed 27 of them. Foreman fought back and landed 10. But a very compromised Yuri Foreman is in big trouble in Yankee Stadium as we enter round 8.
Sometimes we see fighters who look for excuses. This is not Yuri Foreman. He's not trying to use this injury as an excuse at all.
He may not win, but he's going to remake his whole reputation.
And he's still fighting to win.
Yes, he is. I think his own corner did him more damage than the other corner should have done, because had I been Cotto's corner, I would have tried to leave as much water on the floor as possible to keep his knee given out. But Yuri's corner ended up with more water on the floor, which is going to cause Yuri a problem if he gets trapped in his own corner.
I imagine that Emmanuel Stewart told Miguel Cotto not to take any unnecessary risks, simply to keep boxing and keep Cotto in front of it, or keep Foreman in front of it.
And use that jab. Foreman definitely is fighting.
A tremendously courageous display by Yuri Foreman. The difference in the fight for those who picked Foreman to win it, and there were many at ringside, was the idea that his footwork and his speed would be too much for Cotto. The footwork is now gone.
Out the window.
And even when he had the footwork, Cotto was a little too much for him in most of the rounds.
Most definitely.
Cotto landing his jab, landing his jab. Foree, Yuri Foreman, knee locks again, almost falls down. Cotto pushes him back to the ropes and fires another combination.
The referee should stay with us so he can't get in that corner like he was doing before.
And the towel comes in from Yuri Foreman's corner. And Mercanti does not have to stop the fight because of the towel. But now, Joe Greer, Yuri's trainer, comes into the corner. So the disqualification becomes automatic at this point. Mercanti didn't want to stop the fight because of the thrown towel.
He's still trying to make him get out now.
Shrugs his shoulders as if
why
to say,
not?
All right.
I'm in control. Why not?
I'll wait. All right.
Timekeeper Kathy Paolillo now using a stopwatch to try to determine where to pick up the round.
Suck it up for a minute. Walk it off. You've got to wait for the clock. Just walk it off back and forth. Walk it off.
Well, Harold, I guess if fans thought that a white towel thrown into the ring was an automatic fight stoppage, now they know it's not.
No, Jim. As a matter of fact, the commission always tells the referees, don't stop the fight if a towel comes flying in, because you don't know who threw the damn towel. If you want to stop the fight in the corner, you tell the inspector jumps up on the apron, motions to the referee to stop the fight.
Now, here comes the towel. And we don't know where it came from, though it did come from the general area of Yuri's corner.
And the commissioner did try to step up and tell him he wanted to stop the fight, but the referee didn't understand what he was saying, so he told him to get out.
It's also a little bit unfair to the fighters at this point when the adrenaline is spent, when they think the fight is over, when they're congratulating each other, to then ask them to continue to fight.
You gotta also understand McCandy's point of view. You don't want the champ to lose his title because the corner worried about him and he's fighting his heart out. I mean,
yeah, exactly. He's impressed with Foreman's courage.
I would want to be fighting too. I would want them to stop mine if I can still go on and my title is on the line. This may be the last chance for me.
Yeah, but I don't know that the corner did the wrong thing, seeing their fighter in a very bad position, looking out for his best interest.
That's true.
Arthur McCanty handled it perfectly for precisely the reasons that Harold Lederman mentioned.
Nice, nice. Foreman blocking Cotto's left hook to the body there. Oh. Cotto comes back with the left hook to the body and cracks it. And now McCanty's going to stop it.
I told you,
the knockout victory that Cotto was looking for.
I told you, left body shot would have did it a long time ago. If he landed it, it was over with.
That was the punch that once defined Miguel Cotto's career. And now, again, for the moment, it does. Official time will be 42 seconds of the ninth round. You saw the relief on the face of Yuri's wife, Layla Lidecker. Here's the left hook.
You see, he throw right hand and get that elbow up, and there goes a beautiful left hook to the body. I think I told you a couple rounds earlier that if he landed that shot, that would end the fight. That wasn't his knee this time. That was that left body shot. Once again, you see a right hand come out to make him pull his hand up for a left hook. But instead of left hook, the left comes to the body, which has been Cotto's signature punch from his early days, and you knew if he ever landed it clean, that was going to be lights out.
And if you saw Bernard hit Hopkins, hit Oscar De La Hoya there, if you saw Arturo Gatti hit Leonard Green there, there are any number of other examples, Roy Jones against Reggie Johnson in New Orleans. You hit a guy there, his legs are gone, he is not going to be able to stand up in 10 seconds.
Especially if his leg is already hurt.
Yeah. Was it Johnson you got with that shot, or was
Virgil
it? No.
Hill.
Virgil Hill. Thank you, Harold. Roy beat so many people, I can't remember them all in all.
It was Virgil Hill with the right hand, actually. It was Glenn Wolf with a left hook to the body, just like that.
So Miguel Cotto gets the rebound from his dramatic losses to Pacquiao and Margarito and the struggle with Plotty in Madison Square Garden. But Yuri Foreman grows as a public entity and as a fighter. Let's go to Michael Buffer for the official particulars.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at Yankee Stadium, this contest comes to an end as referee Arthur Mercati Jr. calls a halt to the bout. At 42 seconds, round number 9, the winner by TKO victory, now a 4-time world champion and new WBA super welterweight champion of the world, Dejamos Puerto Rico, Miguel Ángel Cotto.
Thirty-fifth win of Miguel Cotto's career, 28th knockout, and after having won world titles at 140 and 147, now he has the foothold of a title belt at 154. CompuBox numbers, Cotto landed 44 more punches, threw 48 more punches, landed at a 10% higher connect rate. Through the course of the fight, his once vaunted left hook reemerged, first upstairs, then eventually to the body. But Cotto first got on the board with his jab in the early rounds, dominated the first three rounds of the fight, sticking the jab into Foreman's face and body. And now a punch zone look will show you. Punches landed on Cotto. Foreman doesn't go to the body all that much, though he got to both sides of Cotto's body. 32 to the left side of Cotto's head. A lot of those were those straight right hands, right hand leads that did a lot of damage for Foreman in the middle part of the fight. But by and large, the punches landed on Foreman. 54 on the chin, and those 13 to the right side of the body finished with the left hook that knocked him out. Max Kellerman is in the ring with the winner.
Miguel, obviously an emotional moment. Congratulations on a sensational performance. How did you win this fight?
Well, I think we make the plan we made in Tampa. Just working with the jab and put pressure over him, and works, really works.
Right around the fourth round, Emmanuel told you that Foreman may have won that round. He wanted you to regain control of the fight. What did you do?
Just follow the instruction, you know, follow the instruction of Emmanuel. He's the guy who knows, who stay focused on the fight. I'm here, but I kind of lost some things, you know, but he's pretty focused on the fight, and I just follow the instructions.
He went down, he slipped, he was obviously in a lot of pain. He chose to continue fighting. What were you thinking at that moment?
No, I have to still fight, you know. I can't stop because it's fight, you know. I'm pretty sorry because of his knee, but, you know, the fight has to continue.
Then it appeared that the fight was stopped. Did you think the fight was stopped?
Yes, when the eighth round finished, I looked at the screen and I saw his trainer throwing the towel in the ring.
Once you thought the fight was stopped and you two congratulated each other, and then you realized you had to continue fighting, what was that like?
Well, still following instruction, you know. The referee said somebody from outside the ring throw the towel and the fight has to continue, and I continue the fight.
You finally wound up with the stoppage. What was your feeling? It was a left hook to the body. We haven't seen those from you for a while.
Nah, you know, I told you in the meeting yesterday, we worked to be the Miguel from the beginning. And I think that we made the world, you know. Miguel is back.
What do you want next, Miguel? What's next for you?
Just rest, and then we're going to have a meeting with the company and check what else, you know, big names. All Miguel wants is big names, like always.
We look forward to seeing you, as always, Miguel. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The very courageous Yuri Foreman. Yuri, early on, he seemed to bother you with the jab, and it looked like you made a decision early in this fight that you weren't going to get run out of the ring. You were going to fight back. Tell me about that.
First of all, thank God for keeping both of us healthy, more or less. You know, first round was a little rusty. I didn't need to go to the rhythm, you know. Later, I felt better, you know, till the accident. And I was there. Listen, he's a great fighter, and I'm not just. I want to also, you know, try to fight.
The leg went out from under you, and while the canvas is wet, You do fight with a brace on that leg. Why?
It's an old injury. I just wearing the brace just to prevent it.
Here's the slip. Describe what's happening.
You see, you know, you can explain yourself. You know, I was making side-to-side movement, and it just gave up, you know, in a second.
It looked as though you were in a lot of pain. Was that the case, or was the leg simply stiff?